Students, today we will learn about the evolution of computers. Every aspect of our lives in this present era has been influenced by the most advanced machine known as a computer. Initially, computers were used only by scientists and engineers for complex calculations and were very expensive. Nowadays, computers can be afforded by small organizations and even individuals. Computers have now become a basic need because of their usage at almost every workplace. Computers are used extensively in banks, hospitals, media and entertainment, industries, schools, homes, space technology and research, railways, airports and so on. The term computer is derived from the word compute, which means to calculate. But a computer is not limited to perform only calculations. A computer is a versatile device that can handle different applications at the same time. Students, can you tell me who is he? He is Andre Truong, Truong Thi, 1936 to 2005. A Vietnamese French engineer. He is considered to be the father of the personal computer for creating the microcomputer based on an Intel 8008 processor in 1973. Do you know how computer came into existence? The present-day computer is entirely different from the earlier devices that were invented for doing calculations. Let us glance through the major milestones in the journey leading to the evolution of present-day computers. Let us first learn about history of computer. The need to keep a track of numbers led to the invention of different calculating devices. Right from the abacus, the first counting device, many devices were invented leading to the development of computers.
Calculating devices. 3000 BC, abacus. Abacus was the first mechanical device for calculations developed in China. It was made up of a wooden frame with rods, each having beads. The frame is divided into two parts, heaven and earth. Each rod in heaven has two beads and each rod in earth has five beads. It was used for addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. Let me share an interesting fact with you. In 1617, John Napier made a calculating device, a set of rectangular rods called Napier's bones. The rods were made up of carved bones, which were used for performing addition, subtraction, multiplication, division, and square roots. Pascal adding machine. Blaise Pascal, a French mathematician, invented the first mechanical calculator at the age of 19 in the year 1642. It used gears, wheels, and dials. Numbers were displayed by rotating the wheels. It was capable of performing addition and subtraction. The gear principle was further employed in many mechanical calculators. Taximeter is a perfect example of a mechanical calculator. Leibniz calculator. Leibniz, the famous German mathematician, improved on Pascal's machine in 1671. Leibniz calculator was a mechanical device. Apart from performing addition and subtraction, the Leibniz calculator could even do multiplication, division, and find square roots. Now let's talk about early IT inventors. Charles Babbage. Charles Babbage, a British mathematician, is considered as the father of computers. He invented a working model of the mechanical computer called the difference engine in 1822 and the analytical engine in 1833. The analytical engine had five units: input, output, store, mill, and control. These units work like the modern computer. All the computers which I use nowadays are based on it. Store was used for storing the data and mill was the calculating unit. Control unit was used for supervising all the units. Students, note the fact that around 1820, Charles Xavier Thomas created the first successful mechanical calculator, the Thomas arithmeter, that could add, subtract, multiply and divide based on Leibniz's work. Augusta Ada Lovelace. Lady Augusta Ada Lovelace was an English mathematician and a writer chiefly known for her work on Charles Babbage analytical engine. She is considered as the first programmer who suggested binary data storage 0 and 1 instead of decimal number system. George Boole. George Boole was an English mathematician. He solved mathematical problems by reducing them to a series of positive or negative answered questions and linked them with a binary system. It resulted in 1 for positive answers and 0 for negative answers. The system known as the Boolean logic became the fundamental principle for the design of computer circuits. Students, have you heard about Dr. Hermann Hollerith? Let me tell you about him. Hermann Hollerith, an American statistician, invented a machine called tabulating machine. It was capable of reading data, processing it, and giving the desired output. The input was given through punched cards. The punched cards were used to record and store data or information. Okay, students, note the fact that in 1890, the United States Census Bureau used punch cards and sorting machines designed by Hermann Hollerith. John von Neumann. A modern type computer came into existence with John von Neumann's development of software written in binary code. It was von Neumann who started the practice of storing data and instructions in binary code in memory. He also initiated the use of memory to store data as well as program. Neumann joined hands with Presper Eckert, American electrical engineer, and John Marchley, American physicist, in a consulting role, and EDVAC was built using binary code in 1950. EDVAC's concept of storing different programs on punched cards led to the advancement of computers that we know today. Howard Aiken. Howard Aiken was a primary engineer in IBM who developed the first automatic sequence-controlled calculator, the Mark I, in 1944. It was capable to execute long computations automatically. Who is he? He is Reynold B. Johnson, 1906 to 1998. He is regarded as the father of the disk drive. ENIAC. ENIAC, Electronic Numerical Integrator and Computer. The first general-purpose electronic digital computer was invented by John Marchley and J. Presper Eckert in 1946. It consisted of 18,000 vacuum tubes and was 1,000 times faster than the Mark I. It could add two large numbers in 200 microseconds. Students, you will be surprised to know that physically, ENIAC was very large in size. It weighed 30 tons and consumed 150 kilowatt of power. It was 100 feet long and 10 feet tall. UNIVAC 1. UNIVAC 1. Universal Automatic Computer 1. UNIVAC 1 was the world's first commercially available computer designed by J. Presper Eckert and John Marchley in 1951. It was the first computer to handle both numeric and text data. It was also the first computer to come equipped with magnetic tape unit and to use buffer memory. Let us now learn about the generations of computers. Evolution of the present-day computer is commonly classified into generations of computers. Each new generation resulted in the following changes. Increase in speed, storage capacity and reliability, whereby decrease in cost and size. First generation computers from 1940 to 1956 had circuitry of vacuum tubes. The data input operation was through punched cards. Data output operation, punched cards as the main storage medium assembly. External storage was on magnetic tapes. Languages, machine assembly. Examples, UNIVAC, ENIAC, EDVAC. second generation computers from 1956 to 1963 had circuitry of transistors. The data input operation was through punched cards, magnetic tapes. Data output operation through punched cards. External storage was on magnetic tapes. Languages used were Fortran, COBOL, BASIC, PL1. Examples IBM 1400 and 700 CD, IBM 350. Third generation computers from 1964 to 1971 had circuitry of integrated circuits, IC. The data input operation was through keyboard. Data output operation through monitor. External storage was on magnetic disk. Languages used, sophisticated OS were used. Pascal, Fortran, COBOL, RPG. Examples, IBM System, 360, Apple I and Altair. Fourth generation computers from 1972 to present have circuitry of microprocessors, VLSC. Data input operation through keyboard, mouse, scanner, etc. Data output operation through monitor, printer, speakers. External storage on magnetic disk with higher capacity. Languages use. Use of special software for maintaining large databases, RDBMS, C++ in 1985. Examples, IBM PC in 1980, Apple Macintosh in 1984. Fifth generation, the computers expected in near future. Futures have circuitry with artificial intelligence. Data input operation through optical fiber technology to handle artificial intelligence, capacity to think and reason. Language can understand human speech, recognize patterns like faces and other complex images. Now let us talk about types of computers. There are different types of computers with respect to size, speed, storage capacity and cost. Computers can be classified in the following types. Microcomputers. These computers are small in size and cost less. They are usually designed for personal use, therefore they are also called personal computers. They are mainly used in homes, schools, offices, shops, banks, etc. These computers are given different names according to their usage. Examples, Commodore 64, IBM PC. Desktop computers. These computers are designed to fit comfortably on top of desk. Desktop computers typically come in several units such as monitor, CPU, keyboard and mouse, which are connected to each other and work like a single unit. Laptop computers. These computers are small in size and can be placed on the lap. These are battery operated and portable. Okay, students, note that wrong input leads to wrong output. It is called GIGO, garbage in, garbage out. Tablet computers. These computers are smaller and lighter than laptop computers. Common tablets have 7-inch or 10-inch screen. Tablets can be used to browse the web, play games and send emails, listen to music, watch movies, view photos, read e-books and so on. To start any application, simply tap on its icon. Let me now quickly discuss the differences between desktop and laptop computer. Mini computers. These computers are bigger in size than that of microcomputers. They have a higher processing speed and are costlier than the microcomputers. These computers are capable to support 4 to about 200 users simultaneously. They are used in banks, universities and in any other big organizations. Example, PDP-8. Mainframe computers. These computers are very powerful. They are big in size with a large memory and high speed. They are designed to tackle huge amount of data. More than 100 users can use a mainframe computer simultaneously. These computers are used in networked environment. Mainframe computers are very expensive and are used in large business organizations, universities, banks, scientific laboratories, airline and railway ticket reservation, stock exchange markets, etc. Examples are IBM Z series, PDP 10 and System Z10. Supercomputers. They are the most powerful computers with a huge processing speed. These computers are used for weather forecasting, space research, satellite control, etc. Examples are C-Ray 1, C-Ray 2, Param, ETA-A 10, etc. Students, know the fact that Tianhe-2 is the world's fastest supercomputer. It is developed by China's National University of Defense Technology. Param is a series of supercomputers designed and assembled by the Center for Development of Advanced Computing, CDAC, in Pune, India. The latest machine in the series is the Param Yuva 2. Let us quickly glance through the key points discussed in this chapter. Charles Babbage is considered to be the father of computers. He invented the difference engine in 1822 and analytical engine in 1833. Augusta Ada was the first programmer. ENIAC was the first general-purpose electronic digital computer, invented in 1946. UNIVAC was the first computer to handle both numeric and text data. Computers are categorized into four types with respect to speed, storage, capacity, size, and cost. The four types of computers are microcomputers, mini-computers, mainframe computers, and supercomputers.